take a little time to smile. You will find it all worthwhile. When the moon comes up, sun goes down, take a little time to smile.
Freddy is this special, unusual in terms of today, because he is more than one kind of classification. In fact, even though he leans towards the great American standard, he's a performer that comes from another world. He's just a great balladeer, and he's got an incredible knowledge of the songs, the lyrics and the melodies of so many songs that you think you've heard, rare gems of what they call American songbook. But then he knows songs from Brazil, and he knows songs from everywhere. I don't know anybody who has as vast a knowledge of beautiful tunes as Freddy.
L is for the way you looked at me. O is for the only one I see. V is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that...
Freddy is keeping alive good music, and I'm sort of prejudiced when I say good music, the music of people like, well, the first one I heard was by Stevie Wonder, who to me is a wonderful 20th century composer, but so was Jerome Kern, Cole Porter, Rodgers and Hart, Lerner and Lowe. You know, the lyrics at the end and melodies that these people put together are timeless, and Freddie indulges himself in this kind of music, and that's what keeps that music alive, and along with Freddie, because there's still people out there who appreciate that.
Making love is quite an art. What you require is proper squire to fire your heart. But if you say one fine day you'll let me come to call, we'll have a ball, 'cause you're sensational. You are sensational, that's all.
Well, fortunately, that's all I've ever done. I've played music, but no, it wasn't clear that I was going to be a musician, because I used to love the sports, and I still do. You know, I played baseball and football, and that was my love, you know, until I got hurt. I got, had my hand stepped on, I can't make a fist. It caused a bone infection, and so I couldn't continue playing football, so next best thing I could do was play the piano, so this is what I did. And it came out to be my blessing, so that was, you know.
And good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We are here at Jazz 91.9 in conversation with none other than Mr. Freddy Cole. Good evening, Freddy. How are you?
How you doing, Carl?
I'm doing fabulous, man. Always a pleasure to have you drop by and talk with me and our listening audience.
It's interesting when you find true satisfaction in what you do. And I think that's where Freddy is right now in his life. He enjoys his life. He travels all over the world performing for all kinds of audiences. He's moving into better and better venues where people are coming to enjoy the musicianship of the man. I think he can only go up from here. And everything that he is doing in his life as it relates to music will only get better and better.
I enjoy playing in a small nightclub, or I enjoy a concert stage, because I can make a concert stage just like my living room, you know, with the intimacy of our songs. And I worry more about the presentation of what we, you know, of how I present what it is that I do. And then I let the rest stand for himself. You know, people will walk away saying they enjoyed themselves, they had a good time, and that's what it was all about.
Without your love, it's a melody played, a mini arcade. It's a bottom-bed world, just as phony as it can be. But it wouldn't be make-believe if you really
saying? I can't begin to name the guys that used to come over there, but I could come home from school any day. I might see Duke Ellington at my house, or Count Basie, Lionel Hampton, you name it. You know, I remember the first time I ever met Fletcher Henderson. He was over to the house one day. They would stop by. My brothers, my older brothers would be home, or sometime they would just be in Chicago, and they'd come by, and my mother would cook a meal for them.
And I'm sitting by this pretty, sweep out the stars, and I chase that old moon. I fall in bed humming a tune. It's crazy, but I'm in love, 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 love.
We've always been, as far back as I can remember, a sort of a mutual admiration society, the two of us, you know. I've always been encouraging him, he's always been encouraging to me. He's a swinger. He's a great piano player, and a lot of people are asleep on him because, you know, he's known as a singer, and he very rarely gets an opportunity to fit in a jazz situation with just himself appearing as a pianist, a jazz pianist in the rhythm section. He's always accompanying himself, but, man, he can play. You walk on the bandstand with him and a good bass player and a good drummer, you're in good shape.
It doesn't matter where you are, I can see how fair you are. I close my eyes and there you are, always. If you could share the magic, if you could see me too, there would be nothing tragic in all my dreams of you.
It's a timeless type of sound he has. It's not, you know, he can sing today, and what he's singing today, you can listen to 10 years from now, and it'll still sound good. And that's true of a lot of instrumentalists and vocalists in this world of jazz. I wouldn't label Freddie a jazz singer, although he can sing jazz. I would label him beyond a jazz singer, because when you say jazz singer, you pigeonhole him, you put him in a category, and certain people, jazz has a connotation to them that it turns them off. Freddie is a great singer.
We go along, harmonizing a song. I'm reciting a poem. Hours go by, they give me the eye, walking my baby back home. We stop for a while, she gives me a smile, tuckers her head to my chest. We started to petting, that's when I get her powder all over my vest. After I kind of straighten my tie, she has to borrow my comb. One kiss, then I continue again, walking my baby back home.
It is a terrific and swinging piano player. I'd rather hear Freddy Cole play the piano and what he does musically than most of the musicians I hear. I mean, I love a lot of great piano players coming on, but what Freddy does, he gets right to the core of it. He's swinging and he's melodic and I'm smiling. And I mean, I'm a piano player. So Freddy is a guy who entertains me greatly when he plays.
You see, I was doing swell until she fell for somebody else's life. Women, but someone got away with mine. Yes, I was the best man when she married my best friend. I find that people in their busy days now, you know, years ago you never used to hear the word stress. But now everybody uses it. You know, I'm stressed out, I'm stressed, I'm this, I'm that, blah, blah. So this is the way, okay, come in, sit back, relax and cool out, have a cocktail or two, be with your lady, hold hands with her, and relax and enjoy this music. So this is what I did. I call it an invitation to relaxation. If it takes forever, I will wait for you. For a thousand summers, I will wait for you. Till you're back beside me, till I am touching you, till I hear you sigh, I hear in my arm.
He's one who's sort of been in the shadow of his brother, but he has always been just as great an instrumentalist and a singer as anybody on the scene. I think he's fantastic.
And it was the fact that that Nat was the one that was the recognized artist, and Freddie had a late start as being an artist, and people just weren't aware that Freddie was even a musician, because all the attention was on that.
I can understand the frustration of being compared with your brother all the time. That means they're not listening to you. They're trying to hear your brother. And you're not trying to, you know, live on your brother's coattails. You know, you got your own thing going. And Freddie doesn't sound like his brother to me. No, he's got two other brothers, you know. He doesn't sound like them to me. I guess because I've listened to him. You got to open your heart and your ears and listen. If you listen, you'll hear a difference there. If John Coltrane's son sounds just like John Coltrane, what's the point? You know? If Freddie sounds exactly like any of his brothers, then why listen to Freddie? Freddie has a different story to tell. And it's uniquely Freddie's story to tell. So I listen to Freddie for Freddie's sake. I don't listen to Freddie saying, I wonder if he's going to sound like... Even if Freddie tackles one of the songs one of his brothers sang, to me it doesn't sound like his brother.
And forevermore is how you stay. That's why, darling, it's incredible that someone so unforgettable thinks that I am unforgettable too. The unforgettable Nat Cole, huh?
So because you're someone's brother doesn't make you them. You know, I have a brother. I don't sound like my brother. But neither one of us sing, though.
Freddie is Freddie, and if it's brought up, he acknowledges his brother, and he moves on, you know. And when I first saw the album, I'm Not My Brother, I'm Me, before I even listened to anything, it told me that he is his own man, doing his own thing to the best of his ability. And for that, I have to respect him.
Hey, I'm not trying to fill nobody's shoe. You see, my brother made a whole lot of money, but I sing the blues. But I'll say in all sincerity that I am not my brother, I'm me. Hey, I know Nat Cole. He was a merry old soul, and he had loads of personality. Yet I am not my brother, I'm just me.
Past several years, Freddie has really established